Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the podcast. As promised, going to do a bit of a deeper dive on the Alchemy Pay project and do some comparisons to Flexa. This is not an AMP comparison. It just looks better on the thumbnail. But as AMP and Flexa are pretty well tied at the hip, I thought it would be okay for this series. I have been digesting the white paper of Alchemy. I haven't gotten all the way through it just yet, but there are a couple of things that make my spider sense tingle, and I thought I would mention them. I'm thinking the folks who come to visit us, the podcast, they come for our candor. We don't do hype videos, and this is certainly not one. This is something different because Alchemy is something different. It's a Chinese company. Absolutely no doubt about it. And I find that ironic that it's blowing up at approximately the same time that China is cracking down on miners in their borders. Approximately meaning within 6 weeks or so. There is no way to do this video without getting a little bit political. If I do, it is just to make the comparisons to what we know versus what we suspect. I leave my personal politics out of everything. They have no bearing in the crypto market. So, spider sense. Little bit. The sad part about this tingling is that it could still be stupidly profitable if you hold your nose a bit while earning that profit. We're going to be getting into that today, and this won't be the last time we talk about Alchemy Pay. There is lots more to get to. Why you may need to hold your nose on Alchemy right after this. Alchemy Pay is almost certainly endorsed by the state, that being China. The more I dig into it, the more I see those telltale signs of state sponsorship, and is why you will specifically need to hold your nose on this one if you intend to profit on it. This is not financial advice, though. I gotta say that, or bye-bye podcasts. The tokenomics behind this one are not really unique. Max supply of 10 billion, 6 billion lose, 4 billion held specifically for rewards and incentives. Not conjecture, it's in their white paper. Mining occurs through merchant consumer usage and through referrals. They are big on referrals. Further, the rewards are harder and harder to earn as the system matures, takes more effort. This is not unusual in the crypto world. A very big coin that we are all familiar with uses a similar model. Spider sense number one for me is the push for referrals, though. I hate referrals and hate having my money tied to them. It's too pyramid scheme-ish for me. Get in soon, get two people to come with you, they get two, so forth, so on. It's also called multi-level marketing. I don't like that, but that's a me thing. And if you are cool with it, cheers. They are going to need to push this for more merchants to come on board because of page 31 in their white paper. I saw a very alarming graphic, and I recommend you go read it for yourself. Alchemy is at the center of this graphic, which is fine. It's an Alchemy white paper. But the reason it's at the center is because so much of what they will be doing with this one requires massive implementation for wide-scale data harvesting. Going to say that again, data harvesting in the DeFi. I'll let that sink in a bit. I don't know if this is going to be the end of the podcast channel, but I really want to get this information out because they aren't bothering to hide what they're going to do. They are posting it publicly. Let me get very specific. Credit business. Alchemy can provide credit business, develop a full supply chain digital currency financing system, and build a digital financial service platform. Digital currency credit business can obtain higher interest income and promote the use of digital currencies such as ACH and further reduce forex friction and improve asset utilization. For merchants, Alchemy can provide unsecured short-term digital currency loans based on their credit scores derived from historical transaction data. The loan assets include, but are not limited to, ACH and other mainstream digital currencies. Nutshell, merchant bank. For individual consumers, Alchemy can provide limited loans based on historical payment data and charge interest. Nutshell, consumer bank. For partners, Alchemy can provide digital currency credit line and charge interest based on their historical transaction flow within the merchant app. Nutshell, ecosystem lending. Merchants, consumers and partners can also carry out mortgage financing business through smart contracts, depending on their digital asset holdings. Nutshell, mortgage lending. This is straight off their white paper, all right? There's no speculation whatsoever on my part, but let's roll on. Big data business. Alchemy conducts big data analysis on collected payment data. The analyzed and processed data can be exchanged with credit reporting agencies, financial institutions, and consulting companies to mutually confirm the validity of data and model orientation or monetized. What does that mean? Monetized. It means exactly what you think it means. Same thing Google does when you use them. Harvests the data and sells it to consulting firms who mark it up and put it into the hands of advertisers and businesses. Nothing unique here. It's been happening all over the world as long as there has been an internet. The unique thing is doing it with crypto. Now, you can't do it with all crypto, of course. Your name is not tied to your wallet. In most of the world, your name is not tied to your wallet. But in some places, it absolutely is. I won't name names. But I will round it out with another tidbit from their white paper. This one is called Other Incentives. ACH rewards will be given to users and merchants who actively contribute to sharing data. Exactly that. ACH rewards will also be given to ecosystem partners who contribute to the ecosystem. I want you to think about that one. Now, I promised an AMP comparison, and in this case, it is an AMP comparison because everything that it is planning on being done with ACH has been wargamed with AMP. Used in lending, used in mortgages, securities, collateralize anything, asset agnostic. The binding element of all of these features is AMP. The binding element of the features offered by Alchemy is Alchemy. The biggest difference is that they are going to encompass everything from a single source as opposed to multiple entities building on the AMP ecosystem. Flex is using AMP to process crypto. A second entity could potentially use AMP as a collateralized lending platform. Third could be mortgages or escrow accounts, but they are all separate businesses. Alchemy is a single source. Now, why am I even bothering with this? Because, in my humble opinion, this will be the platform that processes the Chinese central bank digital currency. The Chinese CBDC is not anonymous. If you have dug into it a bit, it is digital cash that has your name on it. So if you couple your ID with your spending and perform it on an entity that flat out tells you they are going to harvest your data, what would you expect the outcome to be? Spider sense, guys. All right, like this spider sense. It is an awful gift. Now, here's the nose-holding part. Over time and with scaled implementation, this ACH is going to be wildly successful as it hits so many wickets for state endorsement. It serves financial institutions, credit reporting agencies, consulting firms, huge database, merchant and consumer incentivizations, closed ecosystem. Combine all of this with a state-sponsored digital currency that has your name on it. Just saying, guys, use your imagination. Silver lining, this is not coming to the U.S. There is no way that's coming here. Anyway, folks, look, this is part two of the series. I hope it gave you some food for thought. It certainly did for me. If you have different takeaways from the white paper than I got, I'd love to see it in the comments and I will address them. I understand that this is not the normal crypto reporting one usually gets. and we are not at all trying to be provocative. I'm just calling them like I see them, and I see ACH as state-sponsored AMP. Live stream on Thursdays and Saturdays at 1900 Central Time. Cheers.